God bless you in the precious and mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's another Sunday morning, and we give God the praise for the things that he has done, for the doors that he has opened, for the ways that he have made. We could go on and on and on talking about the goodness and the power and the grace and the love of our God. I'm Pastor Justin S. Lucas, and I'm so glad to be with you this morning, just giving God praise and, as always, giving him thanks. Amen. For everything that he's done, everything that he's about to do. I know you say this is a little bit different, amen, on this morning, but we are not in the sanctuary on this morning, but I wanted to make sure to get you this word. Make sure to touch and agree with you, amen, through the scriptures. Touch and agree with you. Hallelujah. Through all things, we give God praise. We give God thanks. I'm praying, amen, that you are blessed and that you are excited, that you are glad to be with us on this morning. Amen. Even in your home, you get you a little break this morning. It's all right. Hallelujah. But I told First Lady, I said, I need to make sure to still get to the people on this morning. Make sure to still touch and agree with them in the word and in the scripture and in the message on this morning. But amen, just being a blessing to you and coming to you right there in your living room. I don't know where you are. Hallelujah. I'm not sure exactly what you're doing, but I know that this word is going to come forth on this morning. Amen. And we are going to receive what thus saith the Lord. It's been a beautiful week. Hallelujah. God has blessed us even through the storm, even through the rain. God has allowed us to be able to just come, amen, together one more time. Yeah, I said one more time. He's allowed us to be able to come together in worship, amen, and in praise on this morning. You know, I've been an advocate for being in the sanctuary, for being back at church. Y'all know that. I've been pushing, amen. We still have social distancing. We're still comfortable and everybody's safe. But on this morning, I'm telling you, I said, I'm going to still get the word out to them, amen, because there's so many that will be out today. Hallelujah. We're praying for people, amen, with multiple situations, multiple things. Hallelujah. So I told First Lady, I said, well, I'll just continue to carry the load. Amen. Continue to carry the burden and be here and preach and give you this word on this morning, making sure that you get your weekly dose, get you ready for this week, get you inspired, get you going for this week. We give God praise, amen, for all that he has done and everything that he is even about to do. I don't plan on being before you long this morning, as I always say, but we do want you to share this broadcast. I mean, we want you to put this thing out there and reach somebody. Because I believe, even though we're not just in the sanctuary this morning, I still believe that there is indeed a word. I said, I still believe that there is indeed a word for the people of God on this morning. Amen. Whoever you are, wherever you are, I'm truly believing that there is a word for you on this morning. Amen. So we want you to reach and share, get it out to somebody. Hallelujah. Be that advocate. Be that person. Be that go-between for somebody on this morning. Amen. You already know while we're sharing, we're going to lift up God in song. We're going to try to do our very best to do our part. Hopefully we can get you up this morning. Amen. Hopefully we can get you up this morning and just encourage you and let you know that no matter what you think, hey, that God has got a blessing with your name on it. Y'all know this is my jam. You know this is my song this morning. Amen. I just want to sing it. I want to encourage you. Hallelujah. I want to be a blessing. It makes no difference what you're going through. You're going to make it. Yeah. God's going to see you through. So hold your head up. Put a smile on your face. This is another test. It won't last always. So get ready. Yeah. For your blessing, yeah. Get ready, yeah. For your miracle, get ready, yeah. For your blessing, get ready, for your miracle. Oh, I know you've been hurting deep down on the inside, but let me encourage you, it's gonna be all right, yeah. Troubles and trials come to make you strong. Keep on believing. You keep holding on. Get ready, girl, for your blessing. Get ready for your miracle. Oh, get ready, girl, for your blessing. Get ready for your miracle. Whoa. I want you to encourage yourself this morning. I know you're right there at the house. Come on, I want you to encourage yourself. Come on. Say, God's got a blessing. Come on and say it. Yeah. Say, God's got a blessing. Oh, yeah, yeah. God's got a blessing. I want you to tell yourself that it's got your name on it. Come on and say it. Come on. With my name on it. Come on, say it. God's got a blessing. God's got a blessing. I said, God's got a blessing. With my name on it. Oh, God's got a blessing. I said, God's got a blessing. I know God's got a blessing. With my name on it. With my name on it. With my name on it. It's got my name on it. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Got my name on it. Got my name all over it. Oh, God's got a blessing. I believe it this morning that in spite of what you're going through, that in spite of what we're dealing with, that God's got an indeed blessing. I mean a blessing that's coming. I'm telling you that it's for sure to come. You just got to get ready for it. I said you got to just get prepared for it. You got to get ready for it. You've been seeking him. You've been chasing after him. You've been fasting, you've been praying, you've been believing, and I believe, hallelujah, on this morning that God has got a blessing with your name on it. I want you to just begin to declare it even in the comments. It's my blessing. This one belongs to me. This one is mine. This one is mine. It's got my name on it. God's already paid for it. God's already sent it. He's already delivered it. It's mine. With my name on it. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's got my name on it. If you believe it this morning, you need to be all in the comment section. Just get excited this morning. Say, it's my blessing. It's got my name on it. It's got God's blood on it. It's got God's promise on it. I believe it this morning. I said, I believe it this morning. I said, I believe it this morning. Everything that God has promised, he's not a man that he should lie. He's going to do just what he said he would do. I'm giving God praise on this morning, amen, for each and every one of you that's joining, that may be just joining in. I'm Pastor Lucas, amen, and I'm coming to you this morning, hallelujah, by way of the sanctuary, but we're not in person on today, amen. We want to reach each and every one of you guys right there where you are, hallelujah, and just give time for you to be able to get some rest, amen. Not feeling my best this morning, but I told First Lady, I said, I'm going to press on, hallelujah, and get this word out. Get this word out. Hallelujah. While this may be difficult, while it may be a little bit more technical, a little bit more things that we have to do to get this done this morning, I said I think it would just be best for me to just go forward and just do it this way and get the message out on this morning. So either way, you're still getting the word. You're still getting the message on this morning. Amen. Well, we thank God for you guys even just tuning in. Come on and pray with me now if you would. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise for the day, for everything that you are doing. Lord, your many blessings, your hand. I pray, Lord, that you continually use us for your glory, that you use us mightily, Lord, on this day. Speak to my heart, even God, and that you may speak and continually to the people of God on this day. We give you praise. We give you thanks in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Wherever you are on this morning, I'm praying that and I'm seeing that you can hear me clearly. Amen. We've got great levels, great audio, and we're trying to make sure that you get this great word on today. Hallelujah. I'm thanking him because of what he is and what he's done. Just realizing in my life and my lifetime, this my short 35 years, just how good and how awesome, how powerful our God is. How amazing our God is. We were traveling over the weekend and we celebrated Josiah's birthday. Amen. Josiah and Jeremiah with me this morning. Amen. And we celebrated Josiah's birthday over the weekend. Happy birthday to Josiah. Turning 11 years old on Thursday. We went out of town over the weekend and it looked like we celebrate one, we celebrate them all. I even had to lay one or two of them out. And I said, it don't make no sense. One of y'all get something, all of y'all got to get something. Hallelujah. One of y'all go somewhere, all of you got to go somewhere. Amen. But I'm celebrating Josiah's birthday on the weekend and we were traveling. We were going over the road and then First Lady just began to talk. As everybody else fell asleep in the car, hey, man, I think Joshua went out first. Then Jeremiah always goes to sleep in the car. And I look back in the mirror and Josiah was fighting sleep. Amen. Boo was already gone. I had to make sure she was still breathing. I thought, hey, man, that she had left us. Hallelujah. She was sleeping so good. Amen. And me and First Lady started talking and we were going back in time. Literally, we began to talk about the things and how we used to travel. Amen. How we used to go over the road, how we used to have to go somewhere. And back in the day, it was a little bit different. I need somebody in the comments talking to me. Amen. It was a little bit different before the modern cell phone was created. I promise if you stick with me just a few minutes, I'm going somewhere. Before the modern cell phone was created, guess what? It was different traveling back in the day. We used to, on yesterday, we remembered how we used to have a list of things and the way that we used to travel. And I just came out and told her, I said, I can remember when the TomTom first came out. Y'all talk back to me. I said, I can remember when the TomTom GPS first came out. It was like a big old box that you had to suction cup to your mirror or sit in your dashboard. I remember when that GPS first came out, they never really got the TomTom right. They had to always update it and change it. You had one version of the TomTom, you had to get another one for tractor trailers. You had to get the updated version because it would send you the wrong way. I began to talk about that and I said, I can even remember having to go online, hallelujah, and print out, hallelujah, directions for MapQuest. Nobody's coming today, amen. Having to print out directions from MapQuest, hallelujah. Print them out from MapQuest and let them go through the list. You had it where you had to staple it together if you had to go somewhere for real, for real. I could remember having to print out the directions from MapQuest, hallelujah. Going online to find out where you are going. She said, I can even remember my daddy having to use a map while driving tractor trailers. My dad had to use a map. Can y'all talk back to me? Had to use a map while driving the tractor trailer. Looking back, amen, over the things that we used to have to do, amen, when we traveled. I'm telling you, some kids today would never understand just how crazy it used to be. Listen to me. When you think about it now, amen, if you didn't even have a map, a TomTom, GPS, amen, there or directions from MapQuest, guess what? You even had to ask somebody, how do I get there? Yeah. You didn't know how to get somewhere. You had to ask somebody who had already been there before, how do I get there? Y'all talk back to me. I'm telling you in here, hallelujah, that guess what? The cell phone has taken place of all of those things. The cell phone has taken place of the TomTom GPS. Yeah, MapQuest, trying to find out instructions or directions. I'm telling you, you just put that number in there, you put that address in there, and it'll take you everywhere you need to go. Y'all talk back to me. All you got to do is follow the blue line. Yeah, all you got to do is follow the map on the line. It'll talk to you. Oh my God. It'll tell you which turn to take. It'll tell you when you take a wrong turn. It'll correct you when you take a wrong turn. It will tell you. Somebody's there? Amen. Just let them in. Hallelujah. Which way to go? I'm telling you this morning that it'll tell you everything that you need to know. I was looking as I began to talk about it, and I looked on it, and I said, you know what? That cell phone, hallelujah, is so powerful. It is taking place of so many things in our life. Hey, yeah. Look, I said, let me name just about 50 things that the cell phone has taken its place. It has taken over. It has taken its place. Number one, the camera. Y'all talk back to me. The cam recorder. A radio, portable music player, the ebook reader, the calculator, the voice recorder, the GPS, yeah, the flashlight, the leveler, a scanner, a compass, portable gaming device, game console controller, barcode scanner, credit card scanner, thumb drive, portable video player, walkie-talkie, landline, I could go on and on, alarm clock, wristwatch, books, calendars, newspaper, all of these things have been taken over by that cell phone. All of these things, amen, have been taken, its place has been taken, bless you, sir, by the cell phone. Its place has been taken by the cell phone. I know you're looking at me and you're saying there is no way. There is no possible way that these things, hallelujah, could all be included in the cell phone. I'm telling you this morning, I was even telling my mother and father, hallelujah, that all of these things, there was a man that took a picture and he had all of these things, about 60 to 70 things that were laid out on a table. God bless you this morning. Amen. They were laid out on a table, and he said all of these things have been taken over by the cell phone. I need somebody, if you have not looked at the title of the message, if you don't know yet or understand what I'm telling you about, I need you to say three words, all in one. Yeah. Come on, say all in one. What am I telling you? All of those things have now been included and incorporated into one device. All of those things have now been incorporated and included into one device. You used to have to read a map, but now they're all in one device. Now, you know, this morning I did not come here to get this broadcast out to you to talk to you about a cell phone. Now, you know, this morning I did not come to you to talk to you about a walkie-talkie or an MP3 player. No, I come to tell you this morning that everything that you need is all in one. Y'all better talk to me. I said that everything that you've been looking for, it's all in one. I ain't going there yet. I'm not going to rush past the goodness and the mercy and the power of our God. Let me take you back to the Old Testament. I got some brothers with me this morning. God bless you guys. Hallelujah. Let me take you back to the Old Testament. Back in the day in the Old Testament, if you sinned against God, guess what? There were certain parameters and certain things that you had to do, amen, to get back right with God. You had to go out, amen, if you had been found in sin, or if you weren't right with God. As a matter of fact, the Day of Atonement is on Josiah's birthday, September 23rd. And during the Old Testament day, the priests would go into the Holy of Holies, and they would get the people right with God. They would atone for their sins and get them back lined up with God for the next and coming year. I'm showing you that in the old temple days, that sacrifice had to be made with bulls. They would take bulls and slew it with a sharp knife. There was sacrifice that had to be made with goats. They would take the goat even on the Day of Atonement. They would kill one goat and put it on the brazen altar. They would take another goat and place the sins of that goat, the sins of the nation on that goat, and send it out into the wilderness. This is where we get the term term escape goat. The escape goat would bear the sins of the nation of Israel, and they would send it out into the wilderness. Listen to this. There's another one that referenced even lambs that had to be slain. Yeah, even on the day of Passover, he said, take a lamb and slay it, one without spot or wrinkle, one without blemish, and slay it, and place the blood over the doorposts of your homes. We read even about clean birds of doves and pigeons that had to be used in sacrifice in order to be made right with God. I won't even tell you that grain, wine, meal, and incense had to be burned in the place of the holiest. Hallelujah, that we may be made right with God, that we may be made whole again with God. All of this had to take place. But can I tell you this morning, can I share with you over this broadcast that the animals that were used for sacrifice, hallelujah, guess what this morning? They were all replaced by one thing. I'm not talking to you about a cell phone. No, the goats were replaced by one thing. The bulls were replaced by one thing. Yeah, yeah. The lambs and the doves and the pigeons and the grain were replaced by one thing. I said one thing and one thing only. That final sacrifice, that last sacrifice, when Jesus went to the cross, he said, you don't have to kill another lamb. When Jesus went to the cross, he said, you don't have to kill another goat. When Jesus went to the cross, hallelujah, the stock and the amount of bulls increased. Doves and pigeons multiplied. Everybody that was selling them in the market didn't have to sell them no more, because when he went to the cross, he said, there's no more need to get right by sacrifice and the killing and shedding of blood, because when he shed his blood on Calvary Mountain, it reached to the highest mountain, and it flowed down to the lowest valley. It washed me clean, made me white as snow. He's made the last sacrifice. I want to tell you, he made the last sacrifice. I said, there's no need for goats. There's no need for pigeons and bulls. There's no need for the lamb and the dove. I want to tell you this morning that he's everything in one. Y'all talk back to me. I said, he's everything in one. Now, you're saying, but preacher, I need this. And I appreciate God. And I appreciate the message of salvation. But I got need for money. I've got need for this and for that and for healing and deliverance. I've got need, hallelujah, for a man, I hear the lady say. I've got need for a woman, I hear the fella say. But I want to let you know that I read in my Bible that if we seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness, that everything else we need shall be added. What am I telling you? That house is in the name of Jesus. That miracle is in the name of Jesus. That blessing is in that powerful name of Jesus. It's all in one. If you don't believe me, let me read Philippians, the 2nd chapter and the 9th verse, where it says, therefore, God has elevated himself to the place of highest honor and gave him the name above all of the names, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, and every in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue declare that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Let me tell you something here. At that name, it's got everything you need included. In that name, it's got everything you desire included. It's got the miracle in there. It's got the breakthrough in there. It's got the power in there. It's got the miracle in there. It's got everything that you need all in one. I got a small sanctuary full here. It's got everything that you need in one. Somebody say, it's all in one. Say it again. Say it's all in one. It's all in one. You know what? The Bible even declares that there are several names of God. Jehovah Jireh. Yeah. Jehovah Shiloh. Jehovah Nisi. Jehovah this and Jehovah that. It calls the many names of our God. I want to tell you that even in times of trouble, I don't know about you, but I don't have time sometimes to call that name. I don't have time sometimes to call his attributes. I don't have time sometimes to call his characteristics and the things that he's done. He's done so much that we don't have time to call all of that. Then what must we do, preacher? What must we do, pastor? I want to tell you all you got to do. I'm reminded of an old preacher, Elder Witcher. Elder Witcher preached back in the day, and he said, they were on the bus, a church bus, and they were on the old church bus, and they were driving. And as they were driving, I think the brakes went out on the bus. As they were on the bus, the brakes went out. Hallelujah. He didn't know what to do. He couldn't get in his cell phone and call the mechanic. He couldn't get on the phone and call the pastor and tell him that the brakes are going out. He couldn't get in the back and call somebody up here to help him slow the bus down. He said, all I did was call on the name of Jesus. And when he called on the name of Jesus, he said, the bus just stopped immediately. I don't know if they hit somebody. I don't know if they ran over something else. But he said, I didn't have time to call on those other things. I didn't have time to call on those other places. I didn't have time to call on those other people. But all I had time to do was call on the name of Jesus. God bless you. Call on the name above every name. Call on the name that has all power. Call on the name that has all authority. Hey, hallelujah, hallelujah. You might not call him Jesus this morning. Hallelujah. I started this message and I talked to you and I mentioned about those things. Hallelujah. That the cell phone had replaced. And that all of those things, from GPS to typewriter to music player to camera to video camera, hallelujah, to map to notebook to gaming console, have all been replaced by the cell phone. They've all been replaced by the cell phone. Well, I want to ask you something this morning. I want to go down the list. Can y'all help me go down the list this morning? Somebody in here might call God a healer. But I want to tell you this morning that he's everything all in one. You might call him a keeper. You might call him a sustainer. You might call him a deliverer. Yeah. You might call him a way maker. But guess what? He's all of those things in one. You may even call him a protector. You might call him a provider. You might call him a mind regulator. But he's all of those things in one. Oh, I heard the old folks say that he's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. Yeah, a present help in the time of trouble. But I want to tell you, he's all these things in one. God even called him the shade upon my right hand. The Bible said that he's the Prince of Peace, the everlasting Father. But he's all of these things in one. I heard somebody even say that he's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. But can I tell you what he is to me? He's all of these things in one. I want to ruffle some feathers right here. Somebody on this line may even call him the Father. You might call him the Son. You might even call him the Holy Ghost. But guess what? He's all three in one. What you mean, preacher? What you mean, pastor? Those are some of the attributes. Those are some of the characteristics. Those are some of the names and the what he is to us. But I read in my Bible in John 10 and 30 that they were questioning Jesus. They were asking him who he was. And in John 10 and 30, look what the Bible said. I and my Father are one. I and my Father are one. Some scholars say, well, he meant that they're on one accord. He meant that they're on the same page. He meant that they're in agreement. You can try to spice it up however you want to. You can try to chop it up however you want to. Jesus said that I and the Father are one. I want to tell somebody this morning, all of those things you may call him, all of those things you may reference him, but guess what? He's all of that in one. He's all of that in one. He's everything that you need. I want to tell you this, and I'm going to let you go, that I mentioned to you earlier, hallelujah, about not knowing what to do. Some people, if that cell phone die, y'all know you lose your mind. You don't know what to do. I see people in the doctor's office when they're waiting to go back to see the doctor. What you do? You sit down and you get on that phone. Yeah, what you do when you ain't got no time? Hallelujah. You in the drive-thru. You pull out your phone. You don't want to know what time it is. People don't even wear watches no more. Yeah. What you do? You look on your phone. Y'all don't know what to do. Look, people don't even call on the name of Jesus no more because they're calling on Siri. Y'all hear me? They don't even call on the name of Jesus no more because they're calling on Alexa. They don't call the name of Jesus no more because they're calling on the name of Google. Listen to me. I'm telling you here, people don't know what to do if they cell phone die. Think about it. I'm traveling on the road. If that cell phone died, look at the baby. She got her cell phone right there. Yeah, got it all pinked up with a case and everything. I'm traveling. If that cell phone dies and I'm somewhere that I don't know how to get to where I got to get to, I can't use the GPS. I can't call my mom and say, I'm down here on 40. Hallelujah. My mama know how to get everywhere. Yeah, and I need to get home. I can't call somebody and say, which way do I go? I can't look up a map if I ain't got a map. If that phone dies, sometime we feel helpless. Sometime we feel lost. No entertainment. No Facebook. No YouTube. No Google. No information. Hallelujah. No maps. No calling. No nothing if that cell phone dies. Y'all see how we've become so dependent on that phone. People don't know what to do with all of that power in that phone. If it dies, you lose access to all of that information. All of the things that are connected to that one device. Hallelujah. People don't know what to do if that phone die. Well, I got news for you this morning. I come to turn this thing around. What you gonna do if God ever took his power away from you? Yeah. What would you do if God ever stopped speaking to you? What would you do if God ever stopped leading and guiding you? What would you do if God stopped answering your prayer? I want to tell somebody something this morning, that cell phone is gonna die. I was watching a movie and there was a robot in the movie. And the robot said, when the apocalypse happened, I sat down and reserved my battery just in case I would come in contact with somebody else. She said, I've got 15% battery remaining, so I'll spend this time talking to you. And after a while, she talked, she played a song, she made a joke. Oh, but after a while, the robot died. After a while, this evening, if you try to call me, my cell phone, it might die. My GPS may go blank. My GPS may lose signal, but I come to tell somebody this morning, that we serve a God that will never lose his power. We serve a God that will never be able to cut off. We serve a God that'll never lose and have a loss of signal. That name of Jesus will never die. It will never fail. It will never lose its power. It has everything that we need in one. It has everything that we require in one. There's one name given among men whereby we must be saved, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. I said it's in that name. I want somebody to tell it this morning. Come on, in that comment section, just say it's all in one. Y'all talk to me. I said, say it's all in one. Everything we need. It's all in one. That's right. He replaced the doves. He replaced the bulls. He replaced the blood on the altar. He said, I'm the last and final sacrifice. I've got everything that you need. I heard Slim and the Supreme Angel say he's got the cattle on 1,000 hills. He's got the corn in the field. Hallelujah. He's got the clothes on your back. He's got the keys to a Cadillac. Y'all talk to me. He's got everything that you need. He's got the, what they say, hallelujah, got the shoes on your feet so you can walk up and down the street. He got everything that you need. I'm here to tell somebody this morning, it doesn't matter what it is that you need God to be, he'll be just that. I went down a list. Keeper, healer, sustainer, deliverer, way maker, protector, provider, mind regulator. The list goes on and on. Listen, there are things that God have been to you, hallelujah, that I can't name. There are things that he's been to me that you can't name. I'm telling you. But I'm telling you here this morning that God will be everything that you need. Come on, even right at your house. I want you to say, God, I thank you that everything that I need is in you. I'm telling you, come on, tell him, I want to thank you that everything I desire is in you. I want to give you praise this morning that everything I've been seeking after is in you. I'm here to tell you this morning, with pain all in my back, that is in God. Hallelujah, that is in God. It's all in God. Everything that you need. I want to tell you, he made it easy for you. I want to tell you, he's simplifying things for you. He said, whatever you need, that's what I'll be. Whatever you desire, that's what I am. But you seek me first, and I'll add all those things unto you. You seek me first, and I'll provide, I'll bring, I'll give all of those things unto you. Listen, I pray that you've been blessed this morning, that this word, I said, this word has touched you. That this word has made something stir up in you, that you realize that I've got everything that I need. And guess what? It's all in one. It ain't in my job. It ain't in my pastor. It ain't just in my church, but it's in the name of Jesus. Everything you need is all in one. God bless you. We love you. In Jesus' name.